this had someone. Chris, BBTV, we're over in Bolton and I'm joined by the victor here, Callum Simpson, who's just had your eighth win on the bounce, sixth stoppage.
Six on the bounce. First round.
You're not messing about.
Obviously, tonight we've come over thinking he's going to, obviously, opponent's got a winning record. He's ranked over 100 above me in world rankings. Beat two undefeated lads, like national Irish champion and stuff. So we thought we were going to be tough and give us some good rounds. So, but yeah, dropped him three times in the first round. Got the stoppage with 10 seconds to go. So yeah, good result.
You're certainly heavy-handed. I mean, you're proving that in what you what you're doing there. And you're saying there you was knocking him down a few times. But your boxing style, you got a lovely boxing style, fast hands.
Yeah.
You know, you'd think you was a boxer, but you're obviously carrying a lot of power as well. So
yeah, to be honest, that first round we said let's just feel it out. But he come over with a big right hand foot straight away and caught me a good right hand, so I just thought, yeah, let's go then, let's go. And then when I dropped him the second time, I might be the first or second, obviously I've seen a lot of guys that rush in and jump in and get caught with a clean shot, so I was just going to ease it out and then go back into the second round, but Mark cornered him and were like, got on him, so I just had to jump back on him, enjoyed it, good night.
You're making an habit of these stoppages, aren't you?
I know, well, like I said, we're hoping to get more, like I said, he's got winning record, ranked over 100 in front of me, he's a top amateur as well over in Poland, so. And someone said as well, after the second knockdown, he went back to corner and said, fuck me in Polish, after I dropped him to his corner team, so. Yeah. I think, but I seen in his face, as soon as that first knockdown, I saw in his face he didn't want it, I saw in his eyes, and I just rushed on him, yeah.
Well, speaking to Mark then, your trainer, he was saying, you know, they want you to get the rounds and they want you get that experience, but, you know, what do you say, you hold back and don't, you know, if he's there, you'll go for it.
Yeah, exactly that. I can't just go and have a little tap about, I need to be switched on, need to put in the shots together, and like again today, even today, obviously, at the half fifth round, got back on my jab, just a bit of speed, but obviously, like you say, you don't want to give them, people like him, if you give him a bit of confidence, you need to give him something for him to not come forward, and back from that, the way to that is by landing big shots. Because if I'm just tapping away, he's gonna get confident and come forward, which is obviously not what we want. So, but yeah,
I'm sure the rounds will come as you go as you step up. So
I'm not expecting. Like I said, when I'm stepping up now, I'm not expecting to be knocking everyone out first round. I know obviously opponents are gonna get tougher, the rounds gonna go on longer, which again we thought we're gonna get in today, which is why what I'm doing six rounders to try and get six rounds in, because when I step up to eight rounders, 10 rounders, title fights, like I said, I need that experience, that you know, to pace myself. But even though at first round I didn't feel tired or nothing or out of breath at all at first round, I'm doing 8-10 rounds in sparring, like fresh lads and stuff, high tempo. I think my fitness is very good. Like I've got a very high work rate, but like you said, I can box as well. I can box, I can fight, and I can dig it in when I need to. So
You brought a good crowd over here from Barnsley. You're a Barnsley boxer.
Representing
Barnsley. I don't know how many Barnsley boxers around at the moment. You probably
there's a few coming through at the minute. Yeah. There's a few coming through. Yeah. My next fight should be back in Barnsley actually. 2nd of July it should be, hopefully. Good. Coming back, nice little homecoming after I've not boxed in Barnsley now for like 3 years. I've been fighting Oldham, Leeds, Sheffield, so yeah, it'd be good to get back in Barnsley. But yeah, like I only fought 3 weeks ago, I got a first round stoppage again.
I think it was first round, probably.
But yeah, obviously, I only boxed 3 weeks ago for all lads and that family and friends and stuff to come out and like spend their hard-earned money again and come support me again. It means a lot.
It's good, isn't it? And you've got another, I know it said on BoxRec, you've got another one, like you said, lined up anyway. So
I think the one on BoxRec's wrong. It says I'm out in June, but that's been cancelled, that show. Okay. So it's actually the 2nd of July I'm out next.
2nd of July. Right.
Probably try and get me out about three times before that, but I don't know what the minute that's what we're looking at. Yeah, yeah.
I remember seeing you a few years ago, Callum. I came up to Dickie's gym and I was up there seeing Josh Warrington. You were there quietly training in the corner.
But you
had something about you. You looked like, you know, you had that star quality.
You're just saying this now.
I've always worked hard. You're very polite, and I always know that when people. Yeah.
I say obviously, end of the day, like Team Simpson, I can't carry carrying my name, like Simpson name, so you got to carry yourself properly, whether it's in the ring, out the ring, you know, always be respectful and polite and stuff, which I always am. I mean, I represent my family, so we've got to do.
And there you are now, on this road to...
We're going in the right direction anyway. We're not there yet, we're far off, but we're going in the right way.
I know your coach, Mark, he's a real boxing man, knows the game inside out, doesn't he? Well, he doesn't know about boxing, so you're in good hands there.
100%.
you know, good trainer at Dickie's gym.
Yeah. I've got some good lads, obviously myself, Corey O'Regan, Jimmy First, the two girls, Sylvia and Yaz. Got a nice little team. We're all hard work, dedicated, live the life. So yeah, we've got a nice team, especially with Max, top trainer. Anyway, you're right, yeah? Yeah, nice one, thank you, mate.
Good build tonight, wasn't it?
Yeah, good, some good fights. Yeah. A lot of the away guys come to win, do you know what I mean? They come and put up a good fight, a lot of them, yeah, so it were good.
Fights on a good show as
well. Yeah.
Good, nice live feed as well, so it's good.
Well, I know a lot of lads said on Facebook, they all do, had the streaming and stuff, put it up, everyone's watching it back home, they couldn't make it, so it's good. Yeah. Good exposure, yeah.
You'll get home and watch it. What are you doing now for the weekend? What are you going to do tonight? Have you got a nice meal lined up?
No, I'm in work tomorrow. I'm at work, thank you, mate. Yeah, I'm in work tomorrow morning at 8:30, so, and then I'm in work Monday again, back at gym.
What do you do?
I'm the store manager at Tasuti. It's like a retail clothes shop in Leeds White Rose. So you're mixing
that with your boxing and you're a busy lad.
So I'll be working, I'm working tomorrow, and then I'll be back in gym Monday, training Monday morning, back at work, and then training Monday night, so straight back at it.
Do you hope to go full time with the boxing as it
goes
along?
Yeah, hopefully we're open end of this year. Obviously, my sponsor, like Estebulo Care Interiors, and trying to get a few more on board. Like I said, obviously, I've worked full time as well. I've worked since I left college, like for past like 8 years now. So, but now obviously it's getting to that time now where I'm going to like open it to 6 to 8 rounds. I need to dedicate. Like, I'm still training 5, 6, 12. Just saying, 6 days a week, twice a day, most days. And it is hard, but I'm able to like balance it. I make time for it. But obviously it's getting to that stage now where I need to look towards leaving work and just fully dedicating on boxing. If this is what I'm doing and I'm still working 5 days a week as well, then wait till it's just boxing and that's it. And I can recover more and just concentrate on that. So a lot more to come.
But you're balancing for now. But it's important having the sponsors as well.
Yeah, 100%. Estebulo Care Interiors. They're not on there, but Yorkshire Carpets, Morley, Phil
local
Walker,
companies.
Look after you.
Yeah, that's good. Callum, it's been great to see you over here in Bolton and Oldham not long ago as well. Yeah. So you're doing a business, making a name for yourself. Yeah.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you very much, mate.
God bless. Have a safe trip up. Back to Yorkshire.
Down. 10 years.